Hello and welcome to the latest review on The White Pube. My name is Gabrielle Del Puente and today's review is of The Northern Boys. You don't need to know what that is or who that is. You just need to know that this review is not safe for work or kids, unless your work is cool and your kids are too. This review is going out on the 23rd of April 2023 and quite tired, so bear with me. It's like 11 degrees and I'm already sweating. This summer's not going to go well. Okay. I'm at a family party. Granddad's 80th, cousin's first communion, a wake. Any one of the occasions that requires an auntie to buy a new flowy top with sequins around the collar. Or for someone much younger to fake tan themselves to shit. Artificial melanin congealing in the cracks between their fingers. They smell like rust and coconuts and it's disorienting. I'm at a family party, but I'm in the bathroom. Drank too much on too little. I didn't get to the buffet quick enough when the creepy DJ announced it was open. And then one of the uncles, the one who likes people to watch him splash cash on whatever the newest Android phone is, has put 500 quid behind the bar. It's gone midnight. We're not in a city, just outside of one. One of those places between other places. Social club. Old carpet. Low ceilings. Daytime light. Nicotine sepia room. I think this is where war veterans hang out together during the week, but they might just be old men. I don't know. The stomach belted to me is full of cheeky Vimtos, which I wouldn't have been able to afford without Android Uncle. I wouldn't have eaten some tuna plat anyway. I am in and out of here every 10 minutes to piss constantly like I am a key part of the water cycle. White paint, lacquer, chipping off the door, and then there's me just pissing, absolutely pissing as fast as I can because I want to get back to the party before I miss anything. The 80th, the communion, the wake. Or was it a wedding anniversary? On the way out, I accidentally look at myself in the mirror and wish I hadn't. It's like making eye contact with a dog while it's shitting or getting deja vu in The Matrix. Like, okay, it's my face and I look great, I think, but I also really don't. I look lonely and plastered, I realise, now that I have lingered at the view. I think I can see actual mortality on my face. Index of where the happiest place to live is, the healthiest. Not here. I think of the government. I don't really know what that is yet, but I don't like the sound of it. Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary, Bloody Mary. I glare. All the adults are getting older. The kids aren't babies anymore, and I'm allowed to drink now. It was Nan that got me onto the port. Tastes like a raisin-flavoured cordial that's past its best before date. Something I should fucking hate. And maybe I do? The bleach smell in the bathroom is a hazard. I want to get back to the party, but I can see my eyes and I can see all the way through the black holes and I am ill because of it. I want to get back to the party, but I stop to look at myself and think a horrible thought. I don't know if life is going to get any better than this. And this isn't even that good. Where does that thought go? I have to leave. I want to make eye contact with someone else, not myself. With second cousins and the various supporting cast members that my family have picked up over the years. Abdul and Simon and Carol. I can hear the edges of songs even with the bathroom door locked. And I want to go back out there. Because I just reckon that if we shout the lyrics loud enough and in unison, and if we hold hands or have our arms around each other, then we won't be thinking about age or religion or death or any of it. We'll just be singing the song. We already know the lyrics. I'm going back out. I don't want to miss Party Time by the Northern Boys. I want to get all the words right. I've gone to enough parties, I've had enough practice. But when I get to the laminated dance floor and I start rapping straight into Carol's face, I feel as if I'm still alone in the bathroom mirror, and then I vomit on Carol's new sequins. Over the past 7 months, a trio of old white men, old white English men, also known as the Northern Boys, have released 3 songs on YouTube. I, for one, can't stop thinking about them. Call me the neighbor's name when you fuck me. You ain't gotta kiss me. You ain't gotta hug me. Shit. I mean, really, just do something, please. Just touch me. These rabid, sad raps are delivered by 2 ex-teachers, Norman Payne and Patrick Carney Jr. The pair always perform alongside their mate Kev, a disheveled man who can't keep up with the lyrics, so he's not allowed a mic, the same way you give kids an unplugged controller to make them feel included. The videos for the 3 songs, Party Time, Nobody Likes Me, and Give It To Me, bring us to a park, a bowling green, and a social club in Sutton Coldfield in the West Midlands. The final location being where I find myself spiritually, horrifically transported to every time I hear them frothing at the mouth over the familiar instrumentals of Estelle's American Boy and Calvin Harris's Acceptable in the 80s, songs I probably last heard at these kinds of family parties. I'm like, hello. I'm like, hi. Do you want a back rub? Do you want to die? Do you want to catch up? Do you want to cry? Do you want a slice of the painful pie? The Northern Boys make comedy songs, but they're bruised, black and blue. Lyrics often more worrying than funny. Whiplash as coping mechanism, like going on an old roller coaster because it looks like it's about to fall apart, so it's going to be more fun. They rap about drugs, shagging, anxiety, dying, ex-wives, the LGBT plus community, and just generally about going mental. And I know this isn't music that people would expect me to enjoy. My favourite bands are probably Wolf Alice and Low Roar, and this text is hard to get right because I'm not sure enjoyment is the word I want to use, and I'm less sure I want to undermine my appreciation of the band by implying I don't wholeheartedly enjoy them. I just think there's something else going on, something more interesting. It might be fulfillment or recognition, reassurance. This is inexplicable old man drill with dark and vulgar writing. It's an intense looking bald man in cargo shorts pulled in with a bright red belt, gyrating in the middle of the day and sounding like someone has 2 hands around his throat when he grovels out the lines. I'm not alone, the voice in my head tells me I'm handsome and great in bed. When you got chocolate, who needs sex? I can just wank to a text instead. And yet, even though on paper I shouldn't like this music as much as I do, it happens to be exactly what I need to hear right now. Enter this into Eurovision, the YouTube comments say, and I agree. I can't think of anything more deeply English to represent us. And that representation is a good punchline. Old white men are hateable. They are supposed to be in charge of the world or whatever, but class cuts through us all, and some of us aren't even in charge of ourselves. I reckon these lot are in their 60s and 70s, and I don't understand how they're doing it, because our life expectancy isn't great up here. Old white men are supposed to represent power, violence, and even right-wing conservative predatory values, but the Northern Boys never reach that level of arrogance. Because they know how embarrassing it is to be alive. If a line ever gets close to a brag, the next one shows it up. Bachelor pad, covered in spaff, Dorito crumbs all up in my bath. If a line ever feels overtly sexual, the next one is about consent, STDs, or outright rejection. I said, hello there, can I fill your hole? She took one look and she told me no. And if a line ever starts to feel like it's waving St. George's flag to rally the terrible majority, the next line starts waving a rainbow flag instead. 1, 2, 3 to the bastard, 4, my ex-wife is a bastard whore, 5, 6 to the bastard, 7, kick us in the balls like David Beckham, 8, 9 to the bastard, 10, pecking on a crotch like a free-range hen, raising a glass to the gays and the bis and the trans and the girls and the big bald men. These boys should be representing us at Eurovision, another YouTube comment says. Unironically, one of the best pride songs I've ever heard. Just put it in. Let the whole world see how depressed we really are. Nil pois. Let Norman Payne and Patrick Carney Jr. and an unmiked Kev sing, it's party time, get your drugs out. If you want to make love, get your muffs out. It's party time, get your drugs out. Do you want to make love to a sad old man? The British Empire is that sad old man. It's perfect. In these short and brutal rhymes, the Northern boys get to the core of something very familiar to me. Just this, like, grim state of being where everything is futureless, so we might as well be animals. You know, I go to very boring exhibitions. I listen to even more boring short stories on the New Yorker podcast. I watch Beef and Swarm. I relate to some things that some people say sometimes. But then I hear a line like, I love drugs and sketchy pills, but my favorite ones are the ones that kill quickly. When I go, will my loved ones miss me? Well, the answer's no. And even though I don't do drugs, I find myself instantly accepting what they have to say. It just gets to a point where I can't be doing with art in any form that still has the energy to dress up nicely and give us a clever little metaphor. I'm too tired. I only want art that stares at the sun for a stupid amount of time, or at itself in a bathroom mirror, smashed and existential. I want art that admits there's a badness growing over us plebs like the mould in the beige houses we rent from jobless kings and queens. I want to read books and watch films and listen to songs that are like massive red stop signs, air raid sirens, a slap in the face, a cold shower. So much culture talks around the weirdness of life, going around and around and only brushing past the topic so as not to alienate anybody and so as not to embarrass the creator for really going there. I'm just finding lately that the flowery shit is what feels off-putting because I'm already off-put. After 2 years of long COVID, I got COVID again, and I'm back to spending most days rotting in bed. Is this it for me now? Post-viral illness with eternal possibility for reinfection. On one of those bed days, I got a call that someone I love has died. Tell me why the funeral is scheduled for 4 weeks after the fact. Tell me why the local paper wants 3 figures to put in a funeral notice. I'm working on 2 texts right now, this review and the eulogy. So, black comedy it is. You know when things are so bad, you have to laugh. When Patrick Carney Jr. sings, hang myself in the neighbour's garden when he comes back, that's a nice surprise. I do. I laugh. It's all out of our control. And yeah, at times, rhymes come to an end with a bit of a childish thud. Flaking skin on my head, sunburnt flesh, let it shed. There are times in the songs when it feels like words were chosen for rhyme over relevancy. Brother, look, wank myself with a fing- Brother, look, wank myself with a single finger, Captain Hook. Then I go smoke my pipe with a random man in a dark and weary nook. The sheds and the weary nooks come off like speed bumps in the road, but even there it feels like a happy accident to help with pacing and overall aesthetic. If it seems a bit rowdy year 9 music class in an all-boys school at times, well, there's nothing like an angry metaphor from a school kid to make you remember how bad it can feel to be a body in this world when, like, we never asked for this. I own everything here, but I'm still wary about publishing this review when there's only 3 songs to go off. The first time I listened to Party Time, my immediate thought was, there must be a millennial behind this. One of their grandkids? Someone who knows that wide shots, fixed cameras, and yellow subtitles do well. And who knows that lyrics that drive a song at full speed to the very edge of propriety, only to slam on the brakes again and again, will curb a good-oiled internet cancellation. See them.us praising the Northern Boys for singing, "Bought a transgender man 2 pints, can I get lucky and fist him tonight?" after so much mollycoddling of trans men as small beans and men light. So much of the experience of listening to these songs feels like a test to me. Like when someone starts at 3 different people with identities you assume they're gonna ridicule in politically incorrect ways, walk into a pub, kind of joke, but then they do not proceed to target anyone's identity, and the punchline is more of a dig at the listener for assuming they'd even go there. I'm so conditioned to watch out for people being terrible, like I am lurking in the shadows of the internet ready to sound the alarm. The fact that the Northern Boys just want to shag everybody without making a fuss about it, God, I think I can relax for once. As long as I stop being so fucking suspicious all the time. Because I still can't confirm the existence of a millennial in the mix, and I feel half bad for still expecting one. The Northern Boys songs get posted to a YouTube channel called Sindhu World, which is an intriguing route to grow from. Based out of an offie in London, Sindhu World grew quite the following on Instagram between 2017 and 2019 by posting pictures with sort of like naively beautiful captions. A picture of a dead fly reads, "Hello everyone. Today Dip told me to come into the storeroom and we saw this. It is a dead fly on the steps. Also, it made me think, do flies ever cry when they die? Maybe one day I will know. Sindhu." A handful of scratch cards on the shop floor reads, "Everyone, gambling is very bad for you health, but this is not gambling because it is free scratch cards. Today, we are giving each person 1 free scratch card to become rich. Also, maybe even you can buy a castle in the forest like a king, because you must always remember, you are a king, even if you are a girl. Happy Saturday, everyone. Also, please, can you scratch with a coin? Because when I did it, I used my fingernail, and it made me feel a bit sick. Sindhu." Smiley face. I mean, this has millennial all over it. That's how Zarina types. But the account had its own characters, storylines, merchandise, and a bizarre interview with Vice until it suddenly went silent. It never declared itself fictional, but there was something going on in the content creation around this very real corner shop that people went and bought Chewies from. A slippage, a bit of fun. It's why I started this text, blending half-real memories with apocryphal songs. The Northern Boys could be a new generation of characters in Sindhu world lore, in which case I trust that everything will be okay. What's the worth? Fuck the universe till it hurts. I'm not used to these kinds of mental health issues. I just want to live in a church and find peace upon me brain. Jesus, please just stop me pain. I know you think that this is a game, but it's not. Now watch me walk away. And that is the review. I'm gonna go because I'm tired and my throat hurts so much just from speaking words. If you enjoyed this, please comment a crying emoji on the video or on Instagram or on your mom. I'll see you on the next review. Bye.